Okay, we're good. Hello everyone, and welcome to the developer stream for Vampyre. I'm Tom from Focus Home Interactive, and I'm here with Philippe, who's the game director of Vampyre.
Yeah, hello everyone.
Yeah, so Vampyre is a narrative-driven action RPG by Donut Entertainment, who a lot of you will probably already know from games like Life is Strange. So for this stream, we're going to jump straight into Uncut Gameplay Live. There's going to be a few spoilers here, so yeah. But nothing too crazy, because you know, you make choices, things are going to be different. So do you want to introduce it?
Sure. So as you said, Vampyre is a narrative action RPG set in 1918 London. So you play as Dr. Jonathan Reed, an eminent physician who just became a vampire and who is now compelled to sacrifice human lives in order to survive and grow stronger. And in 1918, the Spanish flu also strikes in Europe, killing thousands of people. So, yeah, the streets of London are basically crippled by violence, disease, and fear, obviously. So this is a ghostly city.
Mm-hmm. Well, I should mention as well, the game releases June 5th on PlayStation 4, Xbox One, and PC. Yeah. Should have said that at the start.
So we are here in Whitechapel, the poorest district of London, and we are on the trail of Nurse Dorothy Crane, who is blackmailing a vampire friend of yours, Lady Ashbury, the benefactor of the hospital where you currently work at. So the nurse suspects Lady Ashbury of criminal activity, since she saw her visiting dying patients at night, and who were all the patients were dead by the morning, mysteriously. So the nurse demands a large sum of money to keep her mouth shut. And of course, no one in the hospital knows that you and Lady Ashbury are undercover vampires. So that's why your friend urges you to deal with the blackmailer as soon as possible. So we are here in Whitechapel. Your investigations leads you to this house because it seems that the nurse runs a rogue dispensary.
What do you want? Leave me alone.
Good evening, sir. I'm Dr. Reed. I'm looking for Nurse Dorothy Crane.
There is no Dorothy Crane here. Now goodbye.
I'm afraid this medical leaflet says the opposite, sir.
Really? Well, I'm afraid I'm going to close this door right now. Go bother someone else, Mr. Doctor.
Well, it looks like Darius is blocking the access to the dispensary, really. So hopefully, thanks to his super senses, our vampire is able to spy on citizens, and he can, for example, eavesdrop on conversations from a distance. So let's do it.
We also get a little look at his blood quality. We can see he's got bronchitis.
That's worth remembering. Very useful information.
Strange man was at the door with a pass for our medical facility. I refused him entry.
Darius, how could you know he didn't need our help?
His clothes were too finely tailored to be from Whitechapel.
Perhaps just the friend of that stray poet who is always about.
Richard Nidderkot? No, not of the same cloth, this man. I suspect some machination from that journalist.
Clayton Darby? Is he still asking questions?
Yes. I saw him drifting around St. Mary's Church. I swear he is tracking me just downwind.
Okay, so let's try to learn more about the poet and the journalist.
They told us about that journalist or the poet.
Got some leads.
They must know about Darius.
And you know, despite the late hour, the violence and the epidemic, some citizens are still awake. And what makes RPG so unique is that each of them is a potential prey for you to feed on when the time comes. And indeed, the blood is the most valuable resource for evolution. So, merchant, crook, priest, criminal, they all have a name, a story, relationships, and sometimes secrets. So you are free to gather information, to gather hints about their lives, like through through exploration or through discussion, for example. Yeah.
What do we got here?
So, yeah, as you can see, we also have access to the blood quality, which is very important information to consider, because the higher the blood quality, the more XP you get if you decide to feed on this character.
Yeah.
And collecting hints will also increase the blood quality. Will increase the amount of XP.
Yeah.
And some people can also get sick, which reduces their blood quality. So you may want to heal them first before taking the lives.
Nice.
Can you see the irony?
That's pretty Machiavellian.
Yeah.
It's pretty sneaky.
It is. Because as a player, you will be constantly tempted to feed on those as a doctor you vowed to protect.
Doctor? Interesting.
And this is... Yeah, this is, I think, very unique, and this will shape your own experience, right, depending on the choices you make.
Yeah.
So, there are no wrong or right choices. It's only about morally ambiguous options. So you really create your own experience. And what's interesting is that we can say that you have the fate of London's inhabitants in your hands. You decide who to kill and you decide who to spare. It's not about do I kill or do I not kill. It's more about
exactly
who do I kill.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so we heard the journalist was hanging out in front of the church.
Yeah. Maybe
we
tried this guy.
Excuse me, sir. Are you familiar with this part of town? Name's Clayton Darby, reporter.
Sorry, I'm new to Whitechapel. But perhaps you could help me, since you're a journalist. My name is Jonathan Reed.
Dr. Reed, the famous surgeon. I'll gladly help if I'm able, sir.
I heard you're investigating an underground medical dispensary in Whitechapel. What do you know about it?
Not much, I'm afraid. They are wary of strangers, and I'm not really an acquaintance of theirs. Why do you care?
It's confidential. Speaking as a doctor, I'm sure you understand.
Are you sure you're not just concerned about the repercussions that a scandal involving a certain Nurse Crane from the Pembroke Hospital would bring?
Without a doubt, you are a damn fine journalist, Mr. Darby. What do you know of her accomplice, a man named Darius?
I don't know much about the man. He's very cautious, never goes out, doesn't seem to have any friends or family.
He never goes out?
No. A few days ago, he unexpectedly did. I followed him, but it was just a ruse to keep me away from his house.
Really? How do you know?
He went to the nearest mailbox, but just before posting his letter, he ripped it up and threw it away.
Goodbye, Mr. Darby. Farewell.
So, according to that journalist, Darius never goes out, but
yep.
He did it a few days ago to post a letter we should try to retrieve later.
Yeah.
But let's try to find the... the poet, who should be also somewhere nearby the church.
Just for context, this is about 6 hours into the game, so you know we've got a few vampire abilities now, not as strong as could potentially be.
Yeah, exactly.
But I guess we'll see in this combat.
Yeah, and Skull is hiding here behind the church, and Skulls are lesser species of vampires, hiding in fountain areas, in dark corners, or underground. And because of the Spanish flu, they have suffered heavy mutations and have recently become very aggressive. So this is part of your investigation to understand how they became such creatures and ultimately find a cure. So about the combat system, it relies on timing, positioning, management of resources. For example, you have the stamina bar that, that regulates your melee moves and dodges, and the block bar that controls the use of your supernatural abilities. You can also use your secondary weapons, such as the shotgun, this is one of your supernatural ability, the claw.
Just for anyone that's only just tuned into the stream, this is a developer stream for narrative-driven action RPG Vampire. We will be taking questions from the chat, but just after a certain point in the quest, just because we've got a lot of information we want to share, and then we'll start answering your questions after that. Okay, we're in a graveyard. Mm-hmm. This looks like the kind of place a poet would be.
It's a right place for a poet.
Oh, okay. Looks like he's been having some trouble getting his work published.
Exactly.
So you'll find a lot of clues around like this, which will might help you in conversation.
So this guy should be the poet we're looking for.
Good evening, sir. I'm Dr. Reed. I would like to ask you a few questions.
Please be my guest. Although I may not be the best informant regarding this part of town, my words speak about that which the eyes cannot see.
Really? Are you an artist of some kind?
I'm a poet, sir. Richard Nithercott, at your service.
May I ask you a few questions about the district?
Extraordinary part of town, is it not? I'll be glad to help you, if I can.
What can you tell me about an old man called Darius?
Darius Petrescu? Yes, I know him. At first, I thought he was only a small publisher. I invited him to publish my work, but his reaction was pretty clear.
Not interested in your talent?
Darius is an old political activist who takes delight in printing tracts and lampoons. Those communist activities only require mediocre writing skills.
So, we have a new useful information we can use later to force Darius' decision. Yeah. But remember when I told you that you have the fate of London's inhabitants in your hands?
I do remember.
Well, let's see what it truly means. Let's start to learn more about Richard's motivations.
Tell me, Mr. Nithercott, why seek inspiration in Whitechapel?
The place is not beautiful per se, but how to explain it? Stirring and challenging.
Do you not think it a little morbid?
On the contrary, sir. Whitechapel is full of life, full of beauty. Just like my dear muse, the wonderful Camellia.
What can you tell me about Camellia?
Not much. And that's the beauty of it. She can't speak, you know. She's a locked mystery who exhales kindness and sweetness.
Okay, so it looks like our lonesome poet took inspiration from a mute young girl he barely knows, Camellia. Mm-hmm. Okay, let's check his profile. So as you can see on the top right corner, Richard has, let's say, quite good blood quality, but is suffering a cold, which reduces the blood quality.
We can improve that.
Yeah, hopefully we have a treatment for cold in our bag, so maybe we can ask him if he wants to have it.
Do you need medical attention, sir?
It may be wise to let you prescribe me something. I don't feel like I should.
Okay, let's give the medicine.
I understand your appetite for words.
So by giving him medicine, it sort of has two greater impacts. So we are improving his blood quality, as we mentioned, which will give more bonus if we decide to feed on him. But it's also going to raise the level of the district.
Yeah.
So the district of Whitechapel, which will hopefully help to prevent it from dropping too far in the quality of life for everyone.
That's correct. And as you can see, now he's recovering and the blood quality is really high. It's very tempting now to feed on this character.
Yeah, he's looking pretty tasty.
Yeah, so let's check his mesmerized level. He has a mesmerized resistance of 3, meaning he's weak enough for us to take control of him and make him regret crossing the path of a vampire.
Do it.
Okay, let's do it. So sorry, Richard. Immortality comes with few sacrifices.
Yeah. So we're just taking him somewhere where people can't see him.
Yeah.
See us doing this.
Death has no splendor at all. Oh, I see it now. I see it. The verses I could write.
Richard's fate is now sealed. Mm-hmm. Our vampire has absorbed all of his memories and therefore unlocked all of his hints. Mm-hmm. And the consequences will arise soon. But first, our vampire needs to rest in order to assimilate the fresh blood in his metabolism.
Sure. We also heard the dying thoughts of our victim, then, which is a bit of a side effect, right?
Yeah, yeah. Every character has this very own dying cue.
Yeah. And there's how many citizens in this game?
60 citizens.
60 citizens, yeah. And all of them have their own stories and side quests. All of them, and all of them can be sacrificed or not.
Yeah, exactly. And they are connected to other people. Like, for example, with Camellia, maybe we can check his profile.
Oh, okay. So it looks like Camellia's been handing out notices for this dispensary.
Yeah, and as you can see, she's linked to Darius and the poet we've just killed before. Okay. So this is what we call microcosm. And every time you kill one of these citizens, it will impact the lives of the others. Their day-to-day routines will be updated, the dialogues will be different, and of course some very specific consequences will arise depending on who you are dealing with.
Yeah. Oh, I see a postbox. I think I remember that being mentioned at some point.
You're correct. This is the letter Darius was about to post, and this is actually a goodbye letter to his children, because Darius plans to start a war on behalf of communism. So as you can see, now we have all the information we wanted to have about Darius, and now we can go back to his house and
Darius is a bit less of a
force him to let us onto
it. It should not be that difficult to incite him to let me in.
But as I mentioned just before, first a vampire needs to rest to assimilate the fresh blood and to be able to evolve. So maybe we can find somewhere to rest, a safe place.
Mm-hmm. So each district has a few of these safe houses, right?
Mm-hmm. There are hideouts everywhere in London.
Okay.
And this is one of them. And hideouts are a safe place where you can rest, but it is also a place where you can craft improved weapons or craft medicine to heal citizens.
Yeah.
Or syringes, which are very useful for the combat.
Things like crafting weapons and improving them, and the syringes is often a good alternative, right?
Yeah.
For if you don't want to be too bloodthirsty.
Yeah, exactly. But of course, it will require more time to explore and to loot the ingredients you need to be able to craft what you want to do. But and it's totally possible to finish the game without killing anyone.
Yeah.
If you want to, and you can also try to find other sources of XP, such as collecting hints, or healing people, or through Citizen's Quest also. But of course, it will be a long, hard road.
It's more difficult.
Yeah.
There's always going to be the temptation.
Exactly. Okay, so this is the crafting menu. As you can see, we can craft different kind of treatments, serums. We can also improve our weapons, one-end weapons, off-end weapons, firearms. And we can also recycle a bunch of items we have collected before, so let's recycle a few of them. This will give us very useful resources for crafting. Why not upgrading a weapon? The shotgun, for example. Yeah, we have enough to upgrade it to level 2. And now you can decide to customize also your evolution. So you have the choice between dealing more damage or reducing the reload time. So what do you prefer?
Reload time, 25% is better than 10%. Simple math.
That's a big number, Okay, here we go. Maybe we can also craft a few treatments, just in case. Okay, here's one for pneumonia. And why not a few serums also, blood serum, which allows you to replenish your blood instantly.
Which are the things that drive your powers in battle.
Yeah.
Looks like a nice place to rest.
Yeah. And here's the evolution menu. So as you can see on the top right corner, we have now a nice amount of XP thanks to the death of Richard, the poet. So now we can decide to exchange this XP into the ability of our choice.
Okay.
So, okay, let's go for the Rage ability, for example, which is a very powerful one. So here we go, and as you can see, our level has also increased in the process.
Okay.
Let's do it again to really understand this very important mechanism with the shadow veil ability. Okay. And shadow veil level 2, and here we go. We are now level 12.
Nice, nice. So you can see ahead there as well that you're not just improving these abilities, but you also, a little bit later in the chain, have an option to specialize them.
Yeah, exactly. This is a way to color your experience.
Yeah.
Oh. So, the following night, the consequences of your action occur. As you can see on the left side of the screen, the health status measures the health of the district. Mm-hmm. And as you can see, it has dropped to 70% in a serious state. And as a consequence, new diseases are spreading in this district, and the prices of the merchants are increasing.
Sure.
So healing people is always your best choice to in increasing the health status and maintaining the balance of the district. Mm-hmm. Because ultimately, if you go beyond the critical threshold, then the entire district will be lost forever. All the citizens will be reported missing, their quest will be lost, and the place will swarm with dangerous creatures of the night. And so it will be a very different experience.
Yeah. But will it ruin someone's game if all the districts collapse?
Even if all the districts of the game collapse, you will be able to finish the game with the ending you deserve, of course.
Okay.
Okay, so let's quickly equip these new abilities we've just unlocked before to try a different playstyle.
And we can head back to Darius now, because we should have the leads that we need to get leverage for entry.
Exactly.
What abilities did you go for?
So we picked up the Shadow Veil ability, which basically turns you invisible. Mm-hmm. And the other one is a Spring ability, which is a very fast gap closer, very effective.
Sure.
And here's the Guard of Pruen. This is a secret faction chasing vampires down for centuries to protect civilians.
Yeah.
But hopefully they won't recognize you as a vampire at first sight. So this is your chance to get out of here. Engage the fight situation by surprise.
Yeah. We're going straight in.
Yeah. So here, as you can see, you can also stun your opponent to make him vulnerable for a few seconds. And this is your chance to embrace him. This is our vampire signature move that regenerates both blood and health. Or this deals strong damage, depending on how you want to make it.
What was that crazy move that just happened?
Oh,
just did a little bit of
the rage.
Rage.
Yeah. So you basically teleport from one target to another.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, right. It's a very powerful one. And I think it's very important to understand that you somehow set the game difficulty by yourself when you play Vampire, because
yes,
the more citizen you sacrifice, the easier will be the game. And yeah, this is pretty unique in RPG games.
Yeah, yeah, because you'll have these big challenges ahead, and
yeah,
you'll always have that temptation to maybe feed on that very nice blood quality citizen that you also happen
to
like.
Or you can just decide to rely on your skills,
but
you have to be very confident in yourself.
Yeah. You really want to players to sort of feel that kind of dilemma.
Yeah. Oh, whoops.
Oh, the ambushed.
Okay. It's an opportunity to use the Shadow Veil we've just unlocked before.
Good job. We picked that up.
So as you can see, this is a good way to avoid combat situations, and in our game you can decide to avoid most of the combat situations if you prefer.
Yeah.
Of course, you may miss a lot of nice rewards to loot.
Mm-hmm.
Then. Okay, so we're back to Darius' house. and thanks to the hints we have collected, now we can force Darius' decision. We can use our mesmerizing skills,
yeah.
to force him to speak the truth.
Ooh, just got a mouse on the screen. Let me just move that for you.
Mr. Petrescu, just 1 minute, please.
You again. Go away.
Sir, wait. Stop this nonsense. I know Nurse Crane is here. Shall we speak man to man, you and I?
All right. Speak up.
Don't you see we're on the same side? We fight to help the poor, sick, and abandoned.
I'm nothing like you, Mr. Doctor.
Yes, you are. You too believe in providing medical care without charge. You know what we have to sacrifice to make the world a better place.
I have to admit your words have conviction. All right, I'll let you see Dorothea. Don't make me regret this, though.
Here we go.
So, I remember seeing that he was suffering from a illness of some kind.
Maybe we can have a quick chat?
If you want to talk to Dorothea, you must go across the courtyard and take the stairs.
We've not been formally introduced. May I ask your name and occupation, sir?
I am Darius Petrescu. I'm here to keep snitches and spies away from Dorothea. And I also run this little print shop.
Okay, let's check his medical profile. So he's suffering pneumonia, which reduces his blood quality greatly. So he has been
serious.
Nice to us. So
I think we can
do. You need some help, Mr. Petrescu?
I am very tired, but that
and
is
of course,
all.
If I want to, I can decide to feed off this character
now. Slow down.
Well, I think
it's up to you, man.
Take this.
A lot of people are watching. We don't want them to see the dark.
It must be my lucky day.
Okay, let's see if we can learn more about the mute girl, Camellia.
Tell me everything you know about
because
Camellia,
thanks to the hints we have collected
florist.
Before about Camellia, we now have access to
doctor,
new dialogue options.
Convinced Camellia is an angel. She volunteered to give out our medical leaflets.
Who is she, really? Do you know where she's from?
She's not from around here, that's all we know. Camellia is not even her name. It's her favorite flower.
You say she has no close family.
She liked that poet, made her smile. But she doesn't smile
anymore. That was all bad.
Not since he died.
She's bad.
No, it's fine. It's for the greater good.
Okay. Goodbye, Mr. Petrescu.
Okay, so I think we can confront Nurse Dorothy Crane now about these blackmails.
We made it to the rogue dispensary, where she tries to legally rescue suffering patients from the Spanish flu. So she probably plans to use the blackmail money to improve the dispensary and probably also to buy medicine to the black market.
Yeah.
So she doesn't seem to be a bad person after all, but she puts your best friend's life in jeopardy.
Let's see what she has to say.
That's a dilemma. Dorothy is also a pillar of the Whitechapel community.
Yeah.
Which means she is a very important character whose fate will deeply impact the citizens of the district.
Yeah, just for anyone who's just recently tuned in, this is a Vampire. It's a narrative-driven action RPG from Don't Nod Entertainment. So the quest that we're doing right now, we've been investigating these blackmails in the hospital where we work, and we're about to confront the culprit.
I need help!
Looks like
what do we have here, nurse?
Patient Razvan Vasily, high fever running on 3 days. Complaints of dizziness, muscle aches, head pain, diagnosed with influenza.
Treatment?
Aspirin and salicin for the fever and discomfort, liquids for dehydration, but he's having trouble keeping even water down.
Aspirin and salicin, you say? Why not some warm milk and a kiss on the cheek? Where are the quinine salts?
Tried buying, borrowing, even stealing. There's none to be found, Doctor.
He's not convulsing, he's choking. He's not getting any air. Scalpel! Hand me that scalpel!
What can I do, Doctor?
It's too dangerous to operate with these convulsions. Sedative, nurse. Do we have any anesthetics?
I'm sorry, Doctor. None at all.
I need to perform a tracheostomy. Short pipe. That rubber tube will do. We're going to cut a passage for air through the neck.
Yes, Doctor. He's breathing again, but he's coughing up blood.
Internal hemorrhaging. I need to make another incision into the chest cavity to drain the fluids from the lung. Prepare another tube.
A thoracostomy? Doctor, we've nothing to fight the infection. We need an aseptic environment.
Don't question me, nurse. I need a drain. Now.
Yes, Doctor. He's still bleeding, Doctor. I'm losing his pulse.
The drain must have punctured the intercostal artery. There's too much blood.
Are you all right, Doctor?
I can't see.
So you'll notice that his face is a bit messed up. And why is that?
It's because we have already killed too many citizens, actually. Mm-hmm. You are going slowly but surely to your real nature of the monster you are. Mm-hmm. So the more citizens you kill, the more your face will change and become
Allow me
more
to finish
monstrous.
The procedure alone. I need the room.
I'd prefer to stay and see this through. This is my patient, Doctor. I have needle and thread for stitching the wound.
Good. The stitches are holding. How's he doing?
We're losing him. We've lost his pulse. He's dying, Doctor!
A dose of epinephrine, now.
Yes, Doctor. We've lost the pulse. He's gone, Doctor.
Yes. We did everything we could.
Truly? Everything you could. Is that how you'll report this in your log? Is this how the war went? Piling up one poor corpse beside the next?
This was not an influenza-induced seizure. I've never seen symptoms like these on the continent.
Neither have I. But the previous symptoms leading up to this attack were the same, indistinguishable from the epidemic.
No. There was something more vile in these reactions. Something primitive.
There have been numerous reports of mental breakdowns caused by the fever that accompanies the flu itself, Doctor.
Yes, but...
So yeah, Jonathan's ultimate goal is to find a cure. Understand what happened to the people who are being transformed into skulls, you know?
Yeah.
So he's conducting research throughout London to understand where it came from and try to determine if the Spanish flu is somehow connected to this vampiric virus.
Yeah.
So maybe this blood sample will give him the answers he's looking for. So what was this man about to turn into a skull too? So could this dispensary become a dangerous place, a source of infection?
This is an
I think it's time to confront Dorothy and make a crucial decision.
I suspect it was more than intuition alone that led you to us. So, how might I be of service, Dr. Reed?
I've come to put an end to this insufferable blackmailing, Dorothy.
Doctor, you think your warnings scare me? I've stolen and plied, blackmailed and lied, but what else am I to do? I'm all these people have.
You've convinced me of the sincerity of your actions and their noble justifications. But all the same, blackmail is a crime, and it will stop, Nurse Crane.
So, are you going to turn me over to the authorities?
Well, Now we're facing one of the many morally ambiguous choices of the game. And depending on your actions, it may or may not put the entire Whitechapel district in jeopardy. So what to do? Kill her to put a definitive ending to the blackmail while shutting down the dispensary? Or encourage Dorothy to continue this illegal business, but without insurance of what could happen to this place in the future? And there's also, as you can see, a third hidden option. But you need more hints in order to unlock this one.
Yeah, so maybe if we'd been a bit more thorough in our investigations prior to this, we would have had more possibilities.
Exactly. So what to do?
Well, if we spare her, we don't know what's gonna happen.
You're never sure of what could happen.
Yeah, I don't like uncertainty. So I'm calling it, I think embrace.
Okay, safety first.
Yeah.
Nurse Crane. There is no question that the work you've done here is extraordinary, but this dispensary is incapable of coping with the outbreak. It's only a question of days before the situation at hand will overwhelm us. I cannot allow it. It's my duty to put an end to this immediately.
I'm not ashamed. I did what was right. For in the end, I saved lives and you took them. But we had so much in common, Doctor. Don't you see that?
Feels pretty bad.
There is no turning back.
No, you have
to deal with the consequences.
Yeah. So we're soon, next time we rest, we're going to see, at least on a macro level, the impact on the Whitechapel district.
Yeah.
But there could be consequences down the line. We don't know.
Yeah, of course, there are consequences story related that we won't reveal in this presentation for, spoilers, no spoilers. But this kind of scene have very huge consequences on the story, on the citizens of Whitechapel, and as you said, on the health status of the district.
Oh, I've been tracked down by some vampire hunters. Just having a nice rest.
Wow, excellent.
Totally on purpose. Before we go into the questions and answers, just got a little sneak peek of something cool. In a few weeks, we're going to be running a competition to win this. It's like a special vampire Xbox. So put this together in partnership with Microsoft. So this is an actual Xbox One console. Look, this has got cool stuff inside. There we go. Is this on camera? Yeah. Okay, so we've got a... I'm using the camera to...
This is a steak.
Yeah, we've got a steak.
Nice one.
We've got a special vampire controller. I think we've got some images up, actually. Maybe Miguel, if you bring up some images. Thanks. Yeah, there you go. So stay tuned on our social media networks, on Twitter and Facebook, because, you could be in a chance of winning this. Cool. I'm going to dive into a few of the questions.
Yeah, sure.
So we've been gathering your questions sort of throughout the stream, so I've got a few of them in front of me. So someone asked if we're playing on PC. Yes, we are, with a controller. This is on PC. Is it possible to create new vampires ourselves, like as pets or minions?
Not really like pets or minions, but you would be able to turn people into vampires later on. But it's really linked to the story, so I don't want to reveal too much.
It's not a sort of fundamental mechanic that players can play around.
It's more linked to the story. Yeah.
Romy DBG asked which graphics engine, so this is Unreal 4.
Unreal 4, correct.
Yep. Michael Michelli? Michelli? How much of your inspiration came from other media containing vampires?
Oh, well, we've made a lot of researches back in the conception, and our first idea was to go back to the origin of the myth, to the gothic figure of the vampire. So we took our inspiration with Bram Stoker's Dracula, of course, but also Anne Rice's, novels like Interview with a Vampire, so this kind of references.
But the vampire's really got its own mythology, though. As well as taking inspirations, you have the different vampire types.
Well, we've decided to create our very own mythology based on all the, the folklore that exists around vampires. So we ask ourselves all the questions like, are they suffering the sunlight? Do they see themselves in a mirror? Or do they fear crucifix?
Yeah,
this kind of, do they sleep in a coffin? All these kind of questions, we have an answer. And of course, the most fundamental question, where the vampires are coming from. We also have a very specific answer for that in our mythology. So we are back on the evolution menu, so maybe we can try to unlock new abilities just to change our playstyle once more. So this is the Shadow Mist ability, which is kind of an area of effect, aggressive ability.
Yep.
We can also improve our some passive abilities, so the health, of course. Here we go. We're good.
Great.
So again, this is possible because you have decided to sacrifice Dorothy.
So
we have a lot of XP to spend.
Yeah.
And again, if in our game the difficulty depends on how many citizens you sacrifice, more citizens you sacrifice, the easier will be the game.
So I'm just saying we're on 51% of status. So
that was pretty close to the hostile status.
So it's a good job we healed up Darius.
Yeah.
Because if we hadn't done that, there's a good chance it would have slipped into hostile and we would have lost this district.
Exactly.
Which would be a bit
so close.
Yeah. someone asked if this is a AA game or a AAA game, what would you consider?
I would say it's a AA game. So don't expect something as big as a GTA or an Assassin's Creed or some of these games. But what is good with AA games is that we have, I would say, more room for creativity. We are free to test new mechanism, we can take more risk, just to try something fresh.
Sure.
This is the map, and as you can, I think I forgot to mention that the game is built as a semi-open world, where all the districts are interconnected. So this is smaller than a real open world, but which is good to create this illusion of a more intimate and mysterious world, with a lot of different places to visit, lots of secrets to unveil, to learn more about the lore we've created, to learn more about about what happened to the city since the disease has spread, and different kinds of secrets from the citizens, of course.
Bigby asks if any form of conflict can be avoided during the adventure. So is it possible to not do any fights?
You can avoid most of the combat if you want to, except for this one, for example. It's like a mini-boss situation, so we have boss fights and also this kind of challenging situation. Let's say you can avoid 90% of the combat if you prefer. You can specialize in this stealth ability we have shown earlier, the Shadow Veil.
Switching up some abilities.
Yeah.
So these kind of boss fights are a lot more difficult than regular fights.
Yeah.
These are the real test for the player. These are the ones where you're really going to start questioning, should I start killing?
Yeah.
Or should I start trying to upgrade all my weapons?
Can I rely on my skill? Can I overcome the situation with my own skill?
Yeah.
Which is always possible.
Mm-hmm. Okay, another question that's pretty linked to what's happening right now. So G. Braga, finds the concept of having to make difficult choices to level up interesting. Mm-hmm. But will Vampire push players to make these difficult decisions with a good level of challenge? Is the game difficult, I guess? And how is the game's difficulty sort of tied in with the feeding system?
Because as you have seen before, when you exchange your XP into abilities, this is your way to level up. And maybe you have noticed that the enemies have a level. So if there is a big gap between your level and the enemy's level, then it will be harder to overcome the situation because they will deal more damage. And you will take more damage also, and you will deal less damage, sorry.
Yeah. Catharsis 277 has said it's 1918, so do we meet former soldiers?
Yeah.
And is the idea of PTSD
Exactly.
Explored?
Exactly. We, as you said, we have a lot of citizens, like roughly 60 citizens. Mm-hmm. So it was very interesting to try to create very various kind of archetypes, you know, soldiers, nurses, criminal, crook, priest, lots of different characters.
Yeah.
We try to depict, you know, the situation back in 1980s, where which was a period with a lot of social improvements.
Sure.
With a lot of medical discoveries.
Mm-hmm.
So it was very rich in terms of context to create very interesting characters. And we also tried to create very colorful characters, you know, upbeat characters. Because this is a dark universe, but we don't want to make a too serious game. So some people that you will meet are very funny. And some of them are also references to the books and the movies we've loved when we made research about the game.
Because the games are mainly set at night, a lot of the characters have weird reasons to even be out at that hour.
They all have a good reason to
murderers
to stay
and vampires
awake
everywhere.
Yeah.
What are they doing? Someone's asked, Singlehurst has asked, what are the different districts featured in Vampires London?
So there are four different districts. So Whitechapel, the one we visited earlier, and there's the hospital also, and you have the docks area and the West End area, which is more aristocratic.
Yeah.
And you can also expect to visit a lot of interiors, underground, lots of secret areas. Okay, so we are here in your room. We've reached the hospital, and this is where you work, and this is where you can also sleep and craft. And this is a very important place because you will meet a lot of important characters, story-wise.
Yeah, it's kind of like your base of operations, I guess. It really brings Jonathan, like, in relation to the disease and doctor aspect of the game, because. Yeah, you're always in the game torn between the idea of you being a hunter and a savior of these people.
Yeah, exactly.
Shandy Yuda has asked if the game always takes place at night.
Yep, always, because you had in the beginning of the game you had a terrible experience with sunlight.
Yes.
So you decide not to walk under the sunlight after this.
The sun is deadly in Vampire. It's one of the classic traits that have been kept. I think we're ready to wrap up the stream, unless we have any more questions brought forwards. Anyway, to sum up, this was Vampire, the narrative action RPG from Don't Nod Entertainment. The game releases June 5th. This year, so just in like 3 weeks.
Yeah.
And it's going to be available on PlayStation 4, Xbox One, and PC. Available to pre-order now. Thanks a lot for watching the stream. We're going to leave you with one of our trailers. Thanks a lot, guys.
Thank you very much.
Cheers.
Bye-bye.
Peggy 18.
This age is sickly. An ancient poison, an older rage, brewed in a cauldron newly forged.
You made me! Made me this creature! What are you?
I am the land. You are our champion.
Seasons don't fear the reaper, nor do the wind, the sun, or the rain. You can be like they are. Come on, baby, fear the reaper. Baby, take my hand. Don't fear the reaper. We'll be able to fly.
This makes no sense. None of it. Rational thinking only.
I mean you no harm. I need help.
Die, you fucking leech!
A vampire?
Such a crude word. No. You are now an Ekon, and that you shall remain.
Have the very streets of London become a mausoleum?
The previous symptoms leading up to this attack were the same, indistinguishable from the epidemic.
No. There was something more vile in these reactions. Something primitive.
Are you all right, Doctor?
I
can't see.
Over there! It ain't human! Kill it!
Where is the monster hiding? It's still in England, isn't it?
Take your place among the bearers of the lamps.
One of us! One of us!
I shall return as your judge and jury.
The Guard of Priwen has called for a second great hunt of our kind. And they will stop at nothing to eliminate us.
You believe you're just fighting a disease, but it's you, the disease, Jonathan, you!
We stand upon the precipice.
What prevails in the end, I wonder? The desire for blood, or to be of service to man?
Seasons don't fear the reaper.